Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for stopping by to watch my video. You're very welcome if you're new here. So in today's video, we're going to be making coconut rice. This is a very delicious delicacy in Nigeria. Please, if you haven't subscribed yet, hit the subscribe button and the notification button so that whenever I post a new video, you can get notified. And don't forget to like and share this video, and also drop your comment. Okay, let me know what you think about this video. All right, so let's begin. Yes, so the first ingredient we're gonna need coconut. Yes, so this is coconut with shell. In another video, I'm gonna show you how to take it out of the shell. I already took mine out of camera. So wash your coconut just like so thoroughly and put it in your blender. Add some water and blend. Guys, you're gonna need a very good blender for this, a very strong blender, because obviously coconut is very hard. Okay, so blend it like so and then strain it out. You're gonna need like a chiffon cloth or like a pillowcase. I use a very clean pillowcase, but only in the kitchen. Okay, I don't use this pillowcase for anything else. So just strain it out just like so, squeeze it hard, squeeze it so you can get all the milk out. So this is all the milk I got out of it. Look at that, it's so milky. And these are my other ingredients, my vegetables and my smoked mackerel fish. I have a video of how to make smoked mackerel fish. You can, with your oven at home, you can check it out. Okay, so I'm using 3 cups of rice. All right, you can use as much as you want. Wash it until it is clear, add it into your pot, add some water and parboil it, bring it to a boil just like so, and take it off the heat. Once it's boiling like this, strain it, rinse it out with room temperature water and set it aside so we can begin cooking. All right, so get a clean pot, add your olive oil or vegetable oil, whatever oil you want to use, but add it just like so. I added a very little olive oil because I don't want my rice to be too oily. You can add as much as you want, it's your preference. So add some salt. I'm adding 1 tablespoon of salt. I'm gonna go in with my onion first. So these are my vegetables. That is my mixed vegetable, habanero pepper, onion and tomatoes. Okay, so I'm gonna add onion first. I'm gonna fry for a little bit so it can bring out its beautiful fragrance. I like that aroma of onion. So just fry it like so for a little bit, and then add your tomatoes. So I'm gonna add my tomatoes, and then I'm gonna add my mixed vegetables. So with my mixed vegetables, I have green beans, I have peas, and I also have corn. You can add any other vegetables of your choice. It's your preference. Okay, this is the vegetables I usually like to add in my coconut rice. All right, so I'm gonna add my habanero pepper. Guys, you cannot miss fresh pepper. You can use Scotch bonnet pepper as well. You can't just miss add fresh pepper in your coconut rice. It just usually gives coconut rice that's a particular taste it gives coconut rice. So I'm adding my seasoning cube. I'm adding 3 cubes. You can add more if you want. I'm adding chili pepper right now. Guys, chili pepper is spicy, be careful. All right, I love spice a lot, so I usually just add a lot of spice. I'm adding dry crayfish. Okay, be generous with your crayfish because you need a lot of crayfish for coconut rice. All right, so mix it just like so. Then add your smoked mackerel fish. So I already deboned my fish off camera. So add your smoked mackerel fish just like so, mix, and it's time to add your milk. Add your coconut milk, but you're gonna have to add it gradually. Okay, don't add all your milk in at once, so you because you don't want your rice to be soggy. Okay, so add your coconut milk just like so, add a little bit first, and then after that, later, if you need to add more, then you add more. Okay, that way your rice is not too soft and becomes soggy. Okay, so mix it, taste it to make sure you don't need to add any more seasoning, then bring it to a boil just like so, and then add your parboiled rice. Okay, add your parboiled rice just like so, then mix it, taste it. Make sure you don't need to add any more seasoning. If you need, you can adjust with salt or some seasoning cubes, whatever seasoning you want to adjust with. Okay, cover and let it cook for another 20 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes. And this was 15 minutes later. I checked to see if I needed to add more milk. I did, because the rice was still a little bit hard, so I added a little bit more milk. And I'm gonna just cover and let it cook for another 5 to 10 minutes. All right. So I'll keep checking to see if I need more milk. That's why I told you guys, don't add all your milk at once. Add it gradually, because you want that. You don't want your rice to be soggy. Okay. So this is it. This was 10 minutes later. My rice is ready. Look at that. Look at that goodness. Oh my goodness. Look at that. This, I promise you, this rice tastes as good as it looks. It was so good, so delicious. Try it. Let me know what you think. Let me know. Drop your comment. Let me know what you think about it. Guys, lest I forget, you can use meat as well. You can use goat meat, chicken. But I that's not my preference. I only like to use mackerel, smoked mackerel fish for this delicious meal, for this rice. Okay, so you can use anything else. Please drop your comments, subscribe, like, and share this video. Thank you so much for watching till the end. Until I see you in my next video, bye for now.